Vanessa and Alexa's friendship raises concerns Monday on 7 Delon. Jordan Collier's promycin distribution begins on a new season of the 4400. And Mulalo's announcement sends Tebogo into a panic on Mubango.
It doesn't matter where you start, it matters how you finish. Athletes, we're with you on your journey. Engen, with us, you are number one.
A very good morning to you. We are dancing into the brand new week, the final week of Olympic action. It's great to have you in our company. This is Rio. It's a two-hour highlight show as we wrap up what happened the day before, and day nine was a glorious one for Team South Africa. Our first gold medal, thanks to Wade van Niekerk coming in a brand new world record time in the men's 400 meters. He smashed Michael Johnson's record by 15 hundredths of a second. He set the brand new 400 meter world record at 43.03 seconds. It's a moment that will live on for the rest of eternity, and he did it from lane number eight. The first half of our show is going to be dedicated to, he calls himself At Wade Dreamer, and he has made so many people in South Africa dream a new dream and believe that anything is possible. This is how we start the show off with our Powerade performance update.
Powerade, fueling Olympians in Rio 2016.
So who's going to succumb to the adrenaline first? Van Niekerk is running blind on the outside, and he's set off really quickly. Karani James in hot pursuit. He's already up onto the shoulder of Matthew Hudson-Smith. And Merritt is tracking the Grenadian. The American, LaShawn Merritt, closing the gap on Karani James. And Van Niekerk still wide on the outside. These three are away and clear. Sardinio's tried to come back into it on the inside. And LaShawn Merritt coming back at Karani James. But it's Van Niekerk leading at the moment. The South African now beginning to tire. Or is he? He's pulling away. It's an unbelievable victory by a huge margin. A century of history. And 43.03. I can't believe it. He has obliterated Michael Johnson's world record. It was destined to be one of the great races and one of the great days. We haven't even seen Usain Bolt yet, and this has ignited the stadium. Where did that performance come from?
They could not even get level with him, and there's the line that he crossed in a time that nobody has ever done more quickly and more brilliantly. And the nation of South Africa will be rejoicing now.
Great this rivalry is between the three of them. Merritt in 08, James in London in 2012, and now Van Niekerk here in Rio, with the two previous Olympic champions also on the podium alongside him. What a story and what a race.
Powerade, fueling Olympians in Rio 2016.
From being a prematurely born baby to an Olympic champion, and world record holder. What a story Wade van Niekerk has, and it's one that each and every South African is celebrating in. Tips and Ardo, you've been dancing, man, since the time I saw you.
Yeah, Velinho, this is a golden Monday. It's a public holiday for you. If you're an athlete, don't go to train for in, because we have a gold, you know? So talk to me, Wade van Niekerk, do it the unbelievable. Michael Johnson used to be my favorite all-time gold medalist, sprinter and everything. Now, Wade van Niekerk is everything. If you know him, if you've seen him, congratulate him now through social media right now. Hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016. Because Ditlo Bo, this show is for you, from us to you. This is Rio. Hey. Having a golden moment here.
I can see you. You've got that gold in your feet, so you've got your dancing shoes on. But I want to know, do you have a nickname for Wade van Niekerk?
You know what, ne? I'm going to say it like they say, where he's from, ne? This guy is no longer Wade van Niekerk. It's Wade VR6 van Niekerk, bruh. It's got the table boost.
I thought you were going to give him a nice, you know, like the cheetah's the fastest animal in the world. Maybe like a yacht leopard. Or Google.
VR6. You know what? I don't speak to normal people anymore. I speak to silver medalists.
Hey, Olympic medalist, just like the one that joins us now right here on This Is Rio Live. A man that won a silver medal at the Atlanta Games in the 800 meters, Ezekiel Sepeng. It's so wonderful and what an honor to have you live in studio with us. Thanks for coming through.
Thank you, Billy.
Okay, firstly, I mean, waking up at 3 a.m. this morning to watch that race of Wade van Niekerk. Tell us what happened and how you felt.
Yeah, look, it was it's 3 a.m. that we will not forget in South Africa, you know, watching Wade van Niekerk breaking the world record from lane 8 and winning that gold medal, the first gold medal for Team South Africa, and it comes from athletics. So it's a great feeling, especially, you know, us from athletics world, to have somebody like Wade van Niekerk goes and break that world record, yeah.
You mentioned somebody like Wade van Niekerk, and it's a question that Tips posed to you. Who is Wade van Niekerk to you? You can make use of the hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016 to share your memories and your thoughts on Wade van Niekerk, and I'm going to pose that question to you. Tell us, who is this Wade van Niekerk, VR6?
The VR6, yeah. you know, Wade, I knew Wade since he was still a junior. I remember him running 200 meters at World Juniors. It was in Edmonton. And I remember one of the articles, I think they said he will be the future of athletics in South Africa. He did not get a medal. He was in the final for the 200 meters. He is a former 200. You know, he comes from the sprint background, and he moved to the 400, and he's doing great, yeah.
And we're actually going to take you through his Olympic journey as he came into the Games in Rio as the hot favourite after winning the gold medal at the World Championships in Beijing. What you're seeing on the screen now, this was the first time that we actually got to see him on the track in his heat. And everybody said as he cruised, he looked so, so comfortable.
Yeah, he looked, you know, it heat, you know, you don't need to go fast. I think they ran 45 for the first round today, and he's looking good. You know, he's controlling himself, saving energy. Probably he knew in his mind that when the final comes, he's going to go for that world record. But yeah, he's in control, yeah.
He certainly is. And he was nowhere closer to the world lead and African record that we saw him set at the World Championships, the 43.48 second run that he had.
Yes.
But we all knew that he had something else in the tank. Something big was coming.
Look, after last year, after him winning the world champs, there were some talks that, you know, a possibility that he can break the world record, but we never thought that it will happen at the Olympic Games. The main focus at the Games is just to win a medal. But him doing it this way, you know, winning that gold medal plus the world record, it's something else, yeah.
So before he actually got the opportunity to run that world record, he had to get through the semi-finals. Let's relive what happened in the semi-finals and how he got through to the final and why he ended up starting in lane number 8 for that 400-meter final at the Olympic Games.
Official sponsor of the South African Olympic and Paralympic teams, Telkom, proud sponsor of Speed.
The second of our semi-finals in the men's 400 meters. The first saw five men under 45 seconds, and this one promises to be just as quick. Seven of the 8 men assembled here, James and Merritt already in the final. Can Van Niekerk complete the triumvirate of excellence that will contest the Olympic gold? A big roar for the athletes, and already there's a gap developing between Maslak, second from the inside, and Wade van Niekerk, who's coming up onto the shoulder of Rasheen McDonald and doing so really well. Good run from Cedinho, the really talented youngster from Trinidad and Tobago. He's past the Slovenian and looks as though he's heading in at the moment, although as the stagger unfolds, we will see the South African coming into the home straight. Looking really comfortable here. Cedinho in second. Maslak still trying to find a way back on the inside, as is Verberg. And Van Niekerk just looks so strong in the last 50. Having said that, so does Cedinho. Cedinho takes it from Van Niekerk. Tight for third, but I think Maslak will be the man who came home to hope he goes through as the fastest loser. Not as quick as the first semi-final, but that was unbelievably fast, 44.02. This was quality, though, 44.39, 44.45, and all three of the big boys will be in the final.
Never in doubt for Wade van Niekerk, making the move early on. In fact, his intentions were clear the moment he came out of the blocks. Terrific performance by that man, Cedinho. Don't think we can read a lot into the fact that he's got up and beaten him. He just wanted to get the win. Van Niekerk, though, well, the question is, after the two big guns were able to race each other and tow each other to a really good time, what sort of preparation does that give them compared to what was effectively a soft kill, even though he didn't win the race for Van Niekerk? That will only be answered in the final, of course. By this stage, allowing for the stagger, Van Niekerk was always going to round up Cedinho. But the man from Trinidad and Tobago, who runs such a bold race and put paid to the two on the outside of him pretty quickly, thought, oh, well, I don't get the chance to race Wade van Niekerk very often. I may as well just touch him off on the line.
And I think the other factor that may come into play in the final, James and LeSean Merritt have both won global titles when they have gone into the race being the favourite. I'm not saying Van Niekerk is the standalone favourite, but he comes in here as the reigning world champion. He hasn't experienced this level of pressure before.
And for third, it was Maslak just getting it from Janicic. Maslak at 45.06, Janicic 45.07. Season's best for Maslak, and a national record for Janicic as well. So that's a good performance from him. Here's the result.
Cracking run from Machel Cedinho, coming through with real confidence to take it from Wade van Niekerk. They will take their place in what is turning out to be the prospect of an epic.
Official sponsor of the South African Olympic and Paralympic teams, Telkom, proud sponsor of Speed.
And from that time in the semi-final, Wade van Niekerk didn't look like he was going to be running a sub-44 at all at the Olympic Games, because he'd been so far from it. And some were saying, after seeing that semi-final, why didn't he push to actually win it and get a better draw?
Look, it's a matter of saving energy. When you do round heats, you do semi-finals, you have that picture of going into the final, and you don't want to waste a lot of energy. It's to save that energy. Probably he knew right there, 50 meters to go, that the first two spots, it's automatic qualification for the final, so he doesn't need to go fast. I don't think he was thinking about the lane draws that he's going to get, which lane draw for him was just to make it sure that he's safe into the final, and he's got more energy when he gets to the final, yeah.
He's got more energy. Well, he certainly did leave a huge gem, a big diamond, a big gold medal and a world record in the bag, which he laid it all out in the 400-meter final. Before we chat about that, let's take a look at what the family had to say, the reaction of Wade van Niekerk's family, as they were all there in full support, as well as his 74-year-old coach, Tannie Ants Boerter, on the sidelines to watch that world record and that gold medal winning performance. Let's hear what they had to say following his semi-final performance.
But here's the rock star of the second semi-final, the world champion, the fourth fastest man in history.
Well, last night was just an indescribable feeling. It was so amazing just to see him on this world stage and just to be here and feel how everyone was cheering for him. It was just an awesome feeling.
Well, Wade is in a good space currently. He's trained hard for this. We've worked 4 years. And we're expecting a medal that he will bring back to South Africa.
Well, this is the Olympics. It's the big one. It's the ultimate one. I mean, there's no bigger than this. There's no better than this. And I mean, we're quietly hoping for a gold medal. And I trust and believe that he can come home with it.
Van Niekerk just looks so strong in the last 50. Having said that, so does Cedinho.
Well, if I run all out and give it my all, lay on the ground again tomorrow, then I know whatever time comes my way, it was my everything. This isn't just my journey. This is my family's journey. This is South Africa's journey. So it's amazing for me to have my family here, getting to experience the whole experience with me. I'm just grateful to have them here.
What a humble sprinter and what a role model for all South Africans, young and old. Now you, Ezekiel, actually know his mom because his mom was a class sprinter in her own right.
Yes. No, she was. The father also, he comes from the background of running. I think Wade grew up in the family, you know, everything was running.
There's been massive reaction, not only on social media, but around the world to Wade van Niekerk's world record, 43.03 in the 400-meter final at the Olympic Games. And the one man who was the first to congratulate Wade van Niekerk is the man whose record was broken, Michael Johnson. He said, well done to Wade van Niekerk. He said, it's unbelievable to see what Wade did over the last 200 meters of that race. Now, you know Michael Johnson. You were in the stadium. Yes. You've won medals at the same games, at the same competitions that he has.
Yes.
And you witnessed that world record back in 1999.
Yeah, you know, as I said, when Michael ran that record in Seville, we thought nobody will break the record. It's going to stay for long. And now, Wade van Niekerk from South Africa, you know, we never had somebody on the track, especially breaking world records. Those records are tough records, you know, especially when they have been broken by Americans. So for Wade to be able to do that, for me, I think, you know, maybe I'm pushing my luck here. Probably if he goes down to the 200 again, he can do something special also.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think I think the Wade van Niekerk story has only just begun. I mean, the foundations are just strong.
That's the beginning. I think that's the beginning. We've seen him this year, Wade's running, becoming the first man to break the sub-10, sub-20, and also, you know, now breaking the world record. So I think the wait has just started now.
And as we relive those moments from Seville back in 1999, where Michael Johnson, the American, set the world record at 43.18, you were in that stadium, and like you said, you thought that record would stand forever and ever. And if you look at that gap that Michael Johnson had, it's very much like what we saw Wade have, except Wade ran out of lane 8.
Yeah, he was running blind. You know, it's a tough lane to run in lane 8 because most of the top runners, most of the time we see them, they will get lane 4, 3, 5, you know, where you can play with each other. You can see who's in front of you. But running in lane 8, it's blind. You can't look back. So that means you are on your own in front. So, but yeah, wait, something special. I'm speechless because it's running dead from lane 8 and still come that last 100, you know, he was able to kick again to increase the pace. And yeah, it's something special for South Africa.
It certainly is. And in reaction to this run, he said, "All glory to God. I left it in God's hands." And I think that's something that's wonderful to see. Here's somebody that not only is brilliant at what they do, but he's also an incredible role model.
Yeah, no, he's one of the best in South Africa. You know, he's a role model. I think a lot of kids now, they will look up to Wade. You know, he's kind. He's looking after himself very well. And, you know, everybody likes him, you know, in South Africa, you know, in athletics all over in the world. You know, we've seen after the competition, Usain Bolt went to him and speak to him, you know, and everybody Wade. And this is our Wade. This is our world record holder. You know, it's nice to break. Also, you know, as a South African, to say we have a world record holder, we have an Olympic champion, we have somebody that can tackle the sprinters, you know, the Americans and the Jamaicans here.
We sure do. And out of lane 8, this is what happened at 3 a.m. this morning that captured the globe's attention. And it also was a performance that made Usain Bolt ask the reporters to stop asking him questions after he had successfully defended his 100-meter Olympic title for a third consecutive time. And he went over to Wade van Niekerk to say congratulations for this performance, because it was truly out of this world. Ezekiel, just put into perspective for people that maybe are not au fait with track and field, what it means to have the kind of markers that Wade has, a man that can run sub 10, 100, sub 20, 200, sub 44, 400.
It's something that a lot of athletes can do. You know, it's to be able to run sub 10, that means you have to be a specialist sprinter. Now, Wade is done sub 10 in 100 meters, he's done sub 20 in the 200 meters and sub 44. You know, that means it's a lot of energy system that is using the sprint, endurance, and yeah.
When you watch this, did it cross your mind, is a sub 43 possible?
I think it's possible. I think, I don't know, I can say Wade can do that. If he can put his mind on it, I don't think probably himself he was going for that. He just wanted to win, and he was sitting in a bad lane where the two guys, you know, behind him, they are danger to him. So he needs to make sure that when he gets that last 100, he's in front of them or with them. And I think he can do it. I think he can. We can have somebody that can run sub 43. Yeah.
Sure, wouldn't that be something? But for now, let's just celebrate this. I mean, 43.03 for 400 meters. Tips, that's amazing.
You asked for a gold medal. We don't have a gold medal for you. We have a gold medal plus the world record from the VRC. This is a very, very well-serviced VR6. Toko salikuwa, Brazilia. This could be you. It's not umuhulu. This is a world record. Toko salikuwa, baringamu.
Oh man, I think I can only run maybe 50 meters in 43.03 seconds, and that's it. But it really is a performance that has captured the world's attention. And I mentioned that moment about Usain Bolt, and let's actually take a look at it now. And just bear in mind that the last event on last night's track and field was the men's 100, and that's where Usain Bolt successfully defended his 100 meter gold medal. And then he was busy with his post-race interviews, and while he was busy with it, he saw Wade van Niekerk at the top, and he said, "Just hold on, guys, just hold on, I'll be back." And this is what happened.
We were talking yesterday about one of the great achievements in a different sport, swimming, when the great Australian Kieran Perkins was in lane 8 and won the 1500 metres freestyle in 1996. This is a very different thing that Wade van Niekerk has been able to do.
And Bolt was just asking the interviewers there, "Give me 1 minute. There's someone I must go and see in the crowd." And just, we will keep you updated on the high jump. Yeah. He's gone up to embrace Wade van Niekerk.
There they are.
What a moment for both of them. And what a mark of respect from Bolt to Wade van Niekerk.
Two of the men who have lit up the world stage in athletics and in sport in general.
Oh, wow, what a moment. And actually, a couple of weeks before the games, on Twitter, Wade van Niekerk's coach and Wade van Niekerk went to Jamaica and trained with Usain Bolt's coach Glenn Mills and Usain Bolt. So they have actually run together. Here's a tweet from Michael Johnson, the former, now we can say, world record holder for the 400 meters. He said, congratulations at Wade Dreamer to you and your coach. Well done and deserved. Olympic gold and world record. I know the feeling. That is something so, so special.
Getting a message from people like Michael Johnson, you know, Usain Bolt stopped everybody to go. To wait, it's something that as an athlete probably growing up, you know, there was one stage probably in weight journey that he wish he can meet Michael Johnson, he wish he can meet Usain Bolt, but here it is now. He's broken Michael Johnson's record. He's trained with Usain Bolt and he's the Olympic champion. Yeah.
Oh. It's a good way to start the week. Ezekiel, thank you so much for coming into studio. We really
welcome.
Appreciate your comments, your insights into the man, Wade van Niekerk. And remember that you can share your memories, your moments of glory, and how Wade van Niekerk made you feel on social media. Use the hashtag #LetsGoRio2016. It's time now for us to take a break. When we come back, we've got golf. And in the early hours of the morning, we had the conclusion of the fourth and final round and the first Olympic men's champion in 112 years in the sport of golf.
Come on, a six-pack? Who needs a six-pack when you got the nose? Or a nose when you got the soup? Now you don't need a soup when you got the fire. Or fire when you rock those heels. Or when you got the brains. Or the touch. Who needs some other thing when you got your thing? Now work on it.
You get three kinds of mums. The paranoid mum, the cautious mum, and the Dettol mum. She only trusts Dettol antiseptic liquid to kill 100 illness-causing germs, and it's recommended for cuts and scrapes. Don't just be any mum, be a Dettol mum. Dettol, be 100% sure.
Today is a new day, so tell me, what are you gonna do?
Gonna get up nice and early.
Slice. You get three kinds of mums. The paranoid mum, the cautious mum, and the Dettol mum. Only a Dettol mum knows that Dettol cleans away dirt while protecting a family from up to 100 illness-causing germs. Don't just be any mum, be a Dettol mum. Dettol, be 100% sure.
NutriDay Smart Snack presents...
Nunu, what are you doing?
I'm finding the secret code, Mom.
It's back! The Nutri-Day Snack Bar Jackpot! Buy any Nutri-Day yogurt! Find the promo code on the pack! Send in your promo code! Keep your tail slip! And you could win 1,000 Rand every hour, every day! You've won! And you too could be a winner!
Come on, Mom, let's enter!
Enter now and visit the Facebook page every day to see the winners!
Ideal conditions for the final round of the men's golf competition. Great Britain's Justin Rose entered the day one shot ahead of closest rival Henrik Stenson of Sweden. While Stenson had back problems after the 13th hole, he scored a birdie on the 16th to draw a level with Rose on 15 under going into the final hole, a par 5. Stenson teed off first and fired it right. Rose then teed off, and he too drove it right. Little separated Stenson and Rose after their second shots. But as the Swedes' approach shot spun back down the green, Rose took advantage, leaving his ball just 3 feet from the hole. Stenson pushed his long-range birdie effort well past, then missed this return par putt. And after 4 days, gold came down to a final putt. The British golfer tapped in for birdie and an historic two-shot victory. Australia's Marcus Fraser finished the day one over par and dropped from third position to tied fifth with a score of 8 under. And as Fraser sank down the leaderboard, the USA's Matt Kuchar rose 4 places up it with the day's best performance, an 8 under par 63, moving Kuchar to 13 under overall and into the bronze medal position. But the tournament undoubtedly belonged to Justin Rose. He created history by becoming golf's first Olympic gold medalist in 112 years. The winner of the bronze medal was USA's Matt Kuchar. Silver went to Henrik Stenson of Sweden, and gold to Great Britain's Justin Rose.
Honestly, this is just a dream come true. I've been thinking about Rio for a long, long time. Obviously, I've been dreaming about coming here for a few years now, and I was just hoping my ranking and all that would allow me to come and compete in the Olympic Games. And I came in here in good form, and I felt excited about competing. I felt excited about giving it 100%. And then when I actually got down to Rio and experienced the whole vibe of the Olympic Games, I've just been really excited. And to come out of it with a medal is incredible. To come out of it with gold, unbelievable.
And did you ever expect to reach this moment to get a gold medal at the Olympics?
I knew it was a possibility, but there's so many great players. We're all striving for the same thing, and I was in a great fight with Henrik, a good friend of mine today, and it took world-class golf to win today. So I'm very proud of the achievement, and just gonna let it all soak in now.
And how hard have you worked to reach this moment today?
Yeah, I mean, I've had a few sort of fitness issues this year, and in the back of my mind, I've wanted to be 100% for Rio. And I've done a lot of hard work. I've sacrificed a lot of hours in the gym just to really get myself feeling good. And to be honest, things started to really trend up this week, and I felt strong, and my recovery was great. And each day I came out playing my best golf.
It's been a long week. It's been a long month for me. A lot of golf and a lot of good golf as well. So I'm pleased with my performance. It was going to be a battle today. I think I battled pretty well. It was kind of head-to-head with Justin all day, and it was going to come down to whoever finished the strongest, and we're tied coming up the last, and he birdies the last to win it. So I got no regrets, really, and I did as well as I could today, and congratulations to my good friend who won it today.
And what does it mean to you to leave today an Olympian?
Yeah, it's been a different experience for sure. To call yourself an Olympian is something very special, and to be an Olympic medalist is even more special. So, I'm very pleased that I went here, and it's an experience of a lifetime coming here.
I can assure you it's the happiest I've ever been finishing third. Most of the time, third place finish, you leave satisfied, but certainly not excited. And I can't begin to tell you how I am just busting with pride at the moment.
And what does it mean to you to be an Olympian?
To qualify for the team. I was just on the outside and barely qualified, and was so excited. It really was a boyhood dream for me to make an Olympics. As I grew up, golf was not part of the Olympics, and for it to become an Olympic sport, I had so many hopes and desires to qualify for the team. To make the team was amazing, and now to get to don the jacket and get the medal presented around my neck is just such a thrill.
And how hard have you worked to reach this moment, to get to the Olympics?
Well, certainly a lot of hard work's gone into to anybody getting so good at their craft. Anybody here has put in years and years of time, and I have done that, and you know, it makes it feel worthwhile when you get to do something like this.
So congratulations to Great Britain's Justin Rose on what was a brilliant day for their nation at the Olympic Games. We will be bringing you what happened in the men's 100-meter final, where Kani Simbine, South Africa's national record holder over the distance, ended in fifth place and did not disgrace himself, but rather made South Africa very, very proud in a race that Usain Bolt successfully defended his 100-meter Olympic title. We're going to be bringing you that a little bit later on right here on This Is Rio. But the athletics action started yesterday with this event, the Women's Marathon. We've got two athletes, Lebo Palula and Christine Kalmer, who are representing South Africa. We'll bring you highlights of what happened after the break.
Official sponsor of the South African Olympic and Paralympic teams, Telkom, proud sponsor of Speed.
Stand up, today is your day. Now take a step on forward and get on your way. You know what you know. The world's just waiting to meet you today.
With you on your journey. Engine. With us, you are number one.
For staying with our live highlight show of the Olympic Games as we wrap up what happened on a day number 9. Now, 9 is a symbolic number for people from different cultures and from different religions, but it certainly was a golden world record day for South Africa, thanks to Wade van Niekerk, who has made us all begin our brand new week on a high. As promised before the break, let's check in now with what happened in the women's marathon, where Jemima Sungong won Kenya's very first gold medal of the Games.
Hello and welcome along to the Super Drobo, and the ninth staging of the women's marathon at Olympic level is the most extreme test of endurance. The East Africans are expected to shape the race, but history has shown us that the elements, the occasion and Olympic expectation can all play a major factor in the outcome.
And that, perhaps, the best view of the race, if a slightly distant one.
Well, Christ the Redeemer has a marvellous view of the women's marathon. Paula Radcliffe, of course, the world record holder, 2:17.42.
You know, I would say really the conditions in Rio this morning, very similar to those that we saw at the World Championships in Moscow. Bear in mind, Southern Hemisphere, so in theory we are in winter, although of course we're very close to the tropics here. But in terms of a championship marathon, for these women, these conditions not too bad at all. It's inside 20 degrees. Many of these women will have done much, if not most, of their training in East Africa in conditions more severe to this. Perhaps the humidity level will be quite significant. A group of athletes that we breezed past in the introduction with the three Portuguese, and certainly there's one of them, Jessica Augusto. I saw these Portuguese competing in the European Championships just a few weeks ago in Amsterdam, where it's sensible. We've now gone on to a biennial rotation of the European Championships from once every 4 years now down to once every two. And what they're going to be doing is switching in Europe. When it's Olympic year, they're going to be running a half marathon, which for many of these women was absolutely perfect preparation. Augusto and Sara Moreira, who's also in this field, Moreira won that race going away. If we look at the size of the field here, at the moment, we don't exactly have how many information or the full information as to how many athletes started the race. We think it was somewhere just in excess of 150. But in London, 4 years ago, just 116 started. So it's something like a 40% larger field here in Rio, which is quite a tribute to these games, really. Goes to show, just despite the attraction and the commercial nature of marathon running around the world these days, in the eyes of marathon runners, the Olympic Games have quite, on the contrary, really, to having lost some of their luster. They've rather gained more of it. It still is seen, despite the financial advantages of winning a major city marathon, this is the race in a four-year period that every one of these athletes wants to win. Well, this is looking a little bit further down the field to the Australians running well there. Jessica Trengove in that group towards the back of it, just a bit further down the road. Millie Clark. Millie Clark not on that picture, but she's just a bit further behind. And also there is Lisa Waitman, 16th at the London Games. We'll get some idea now of just how far behind the leading group they are. So that's what, around about 100 metres, 200 metres. Yes, the leading group well and truly away. 800 metres, I think, further up the road, David.
Look at the leading times in Olympic marathon running. Galena, the Olympic record holder, 2:23.07, and Takahashi, 2:23.14. Two Olympic records. One was broken, obviously, in London 4 years ago, but favourable conditions. You mentioned those attrition type conditions in Athens and Barcelona. We're not seeing that type of carnage in this race, that's for sure, but high humidity will make it really interesting in the final 10k of this marathon.
Yes, that was the back of Anna Dolce Felix we just saw there a couple of moments ago, and these are the latest splits at 20 kilometers coming through in 1 hour, 9 minutes and 7 seconds. It's a 6 metre gap, a 7 metre gap. This perhaps is where the gold medal will be won.
Well, Kenya have done it world championship level. Catherine Endereba and Edna Kiplagat have won a couple of world titles, but they've never done it at the Olympic Games. Endereba the most successful, and that margin significant. But Kerwa has responded. She's looking to get back on in touch with Sumgong. And this is a courageous response by the Bahraini, the former Kenyan. And she's almost intact now. You can see the margin back to Mare Dibaba. So Kerr is not done with yet. You can see both runners suffering. And we're inside the last kilometre of the women's marathon.
Yes, it stayed there, hasn't it, at about 5 or 6 metres. I must stress that camera angle does foreshorten the gap, but it hasn't increased any. It's only about 5 or 6 strides. And the longer that Kerwa can hold that gap, it'll tell her more and more, although that's looking now about 10 metres. Just a slightly nervous look over the right shoulder from Sumgong. And now Sumgong is kicking just that little bit more. The arms flaying. It's not the most pleasing style, and there you can see somebody having popped over the perimeter fencing. Thankfully no repeat of the drama of the denouement of the men's marathon in Athens from 8 years ago. And you can see the security forces having to work hard there at the front. There's another runner managing to, I say runner, placing in inverted commas, just managing to get over the bars at the side of the course. But the security staff doing a glorious job. But Jemima Sumgong, it's a gap now of about 12 metres or something like that. Here's Dibaba, the world champion, settling for third place, but she's looking comfortable. Sumgong has got about another 3 minutes to go here. She'll be able to see ahead of her the finish to the race. There is the turn, and it's a long run in.
A huge run in for Jemima Sumgong. And Kenyan history is about to be made. She's opened up that gap on her closest rival. And Eunice Kerwa has battled courageously to stay in touch with this runner who missed out on a medal at the World Championships. Her form has been excellent throughout 2016. And she looks to have done enough to the finish line. It's a famous finish in marathon history. And Jemima Sumgong looking to create history for Kenya.
Well, Jemima Sumgong. Well, she's held herself together wonderfully well. One or two peripheral challenges there for the security staff. But Jemima Sumgong stretching her lead. And she's on her way here to becoming the Olympic champion. Kenya's first ever in the women's marathon. A race which was first run for the women in 1984. Joan Benoit winning on home turf. And now Kenya are going to win their first ever women's Olympic marathon. A moment of history.
Absolute history here for Jemima Sumgong. The greats of the past will be surpassed by one of the stars of the present. And Jemima Sumgong to the finish line to win Kenya's first ever women's Olympic gold in the marathon. A wonderful...
Doctors feared that he may even end up being disabled. It's also why when Wade van Niekerk won two massive awards at the South African Sports Awards, he gave R500,000 to the neonatal unit at Groote Schuur Hospital, because he himself was born at a Tygerberg, and he says that parents go through so much when their children are born premature. So from premature baby to world champion, Olympic champion and world record holder. That's Wade van Niekerk. We just saw highlights of what happened in the women's marathon, and Sumgong's medal there for Kenya. The nation of Kenya are hoping that it's the first of many, because David Rudisha will be in action later on today in the 800-meter men's final, where he's going out to defend his Olympic crown. We've got that and so much more coming your way. Do stay with This Is Rio.
Got to both the men and the women, medal races on the windsurfers, and then after that we've got some NACRA 17 racing coming up. 10 men in this medal race, and it's double points, of course.
And I think we'll be focusing on the battle for bronze for men's RSX. We're in sequence. That's the Blue Peter flying. That's a good sign. That's what we like to see. Racing is about to get underway.
Camboni of Italy. Very, very interesting young personality. See how he goes here. Cheng of Hong Kong and Pastor Lafuente of Spain. And away they go. The medal race in the RSX. The men off running. And look at the start of Dempsey. Kokolani's right behind him.
Yeah, Dempsey off the pin end, Kokolanis just slightly to windward, pumping, and that's the real feature of board sailing. It's open slather in terms of the kinetics, as is often referred to. And Nick Dempsey, he said earlier, I want to win it. I want to win the medal race. I want to go out in a blaze of glory. And he certainly has got a beautiful start. Down to leeward of Dempsey, we have got the Netherlands, the Olympic champion here in Rio. Just notice there in this condition, the centreboard's right up, so they're getting enough lift just off the trailing fin. They don't need the centreboard down to go upwind.
What can you see about the Dutchman that makes him so dominant in this sport, huh?
Superb conditioning first up, and just an understanding of how to just optimize sailing very, very efficiently the board. He's a bit taller than most. He's a very tall guy, and he uses that leverage of being able to just absolutely, you know, effectively force the boat up the course.
1 meter 89, 6 feet 2, the 27-year-old Dutchman is doing it again, and Dempsey, his big rival, is up there with him. 1-2 in the series, and here they go. 7 races under the belt of Van Rysselberg during the 12-race series. 3 won by Nick Dempsey.
Saw Kokkolanis tack away. So we must be in the crossover for whether they use a centre board or not. I saw Kokkolanis. He had a bit of board down, but it was the Olympic champion who was just planing off the line at pace. Big just spread right. Now, quite a big spread. And Van Rysselberg will be just not wanting to interfere with the bronze medal group. But look at that. You see the centre board up, just under the foot of the sail. Centre board's right up, so there's very little drag going on there. And to get into the wind, he's relying on the lift just coming off the fin, which is right in the back of the board. Wonderful technique. Great overview. See the twist in the sail. Unstayed mast, carbon fibre, fully battened sail. Effectively, it's going upward with a soft wing as opposed to an unbattened yacht sail. They're very efficient, low drag, and that's why they go so quick.
Superb overhead view of the champion. Spain still in second place, and the British contestant just behind them. Coming down towards the mark, Van Rysselberg increasing his lead. 25 seconds at the last mark. Let's see what it's like this time around. Behind them, by the way, Kokkolanis getting himself ahead of Miuska, and Lecoq is just behind them. Lying at the moment in pretty much 7th, 8th and 9th. It's very close right now, though, between Kokkolanis and Miuska.
Olympic champion Dorian van Rysselberg. He'll come down around the mark for the final time as he goes into the jibe. He will be our Olympic champion. He had that tied up before the last race, before the medal race. So he's gone out and just reaffirmed his superiority. There it is. That's the jibe. Whoa. Probably the first mistake he's made all week. Just lost a little bit of balance there. But centre board up, coming down to the finish. So it's Dorian van Rysselberg from the Netherlands will be our Olympic champion. This is the first medal race for sailing here in Rio. And it is the Flying Dutchman that takes out gold.
The rules said he had to take part in this particular race, even though he'd won the series by a country mile. Already got the gold 2 days ago. Now it's the affirmation of a truly great champion. And the Dutch supporters on the beach there applaud a man who has been absolutely awesome. Van Rysselberg wins absolutely handsomely. 2 points for first place here in the medal match, and that's a total of 25 for him. The Spaniard coming home second, Ivan Pasta Lafuente. Way behind overall, though. Just a nice way to finish for him. Shakes his hands down. It's hard work out there. And the man from Hong Kong making a bit of a charge here. Chang looking for third place.
Yeah, it's a good effort by Michael Chang from Hong Kong. And that whole development of sailing in Asia, and we're seeing it from Hong Kong through China, Korea are having good performances. Singapore, they really are developing quickly. And they've always been very strong in RSX. So Michael Chang coming over towards the finish. His estimated overall will be eighth, but back to Nick Dempsey.
Just to emphasize how well Chang has done here, world ranking of 21. Has some top 10 finishes in the World Cup, but this is a tremendous performance for him in this very last race. The men's RSX. Here he comes, the 22-year-old. He's been sailboarding since 2002. His first Olympic Games. And he'll be absolutely thrilled with that.
Well, and at that young age, he's going to be around for a while, so he'll be one to look out for when the Olympics go to Tokyo. As Nick Dempsey now cruising it out. So Nick Dempsey, silver medal, number two on his sail. That will be the end of a very, very distinguished career for Nick Dempsey. 5 Olympics, 3 medals. Nick Dempsey, start of the week strong. Silver to Nick Dempsey as he comes over the line. He'll be delighted.
Yes, he's been saying just how hard he's worked for all this. Months and months and years of training, as a matter of fact. And it's a great way to finish. Beaten only by the very best in the world. A silver medal for the British man.
Well, I'm sitting here looking further back the field to see who's got bronze as Ricardo Santos comes through, and he will come through probably seventh overall. And I'm looking up for Pierre Lecoq. He had been the strong player for bronze. That was the game as we look, and it is... that's France coming in. There's Poland.
So this is Mieska. Mieska, who is in the best position to get the bronze medal, but look at the Frenchman coming from the other side. It's going to be Lecoq who gets home first. Have to just confirm what the story is in terms of the marks, because double marks for this race. Now they come. So France leading Poland with the Greek just a little bit adrift by the looks of it.
So it does appear Pierre Lecoq from France will take, but here comes Coquelanis. We're coming down to the line. It does look like France will take the bronze medal, but there's only a boat length in it. Over they go, Coquelanis attacking, but it's bronze for the sailor from France. Pierre Lecoq, take a bow.
Gold for Dorian van Rijsselberg. Silver for Nick Dempsey. And bronze, we think, for Pierre Lecoq of France. The Dutch in first place. Van Rijsselberg, Nick Dempsey second, and the bronze going now officially to Pierre Lecoq of France. Mieska of Poland just missing out. Coquelanis coming up in fifth place. The first of the gold medals at Rio 2016 in the sailing.
So congratulations to the Netherlands' Dorian van Rijsselberg. A quick fact file about Wade van Niekerk, our gold medal winner. The 25-year-old first came to prominence in 2011, winning the 200-meter title with a personal best of 20.57 seconds at the South African Athletics Championships. He has gone much better than that since, dipping under the 20-second mark. He's also the first man in history to run a sub-10 100, a sub-20 200, and a sub-44 400. And as we sit this morning, his current world record, his lifetime best over 400 meters, is 43.03. After the break, we bring you tennis. Stay with This Is Rio.
You get three kinds of mums: the paranoid mum, the cautious mum, and the Dettol mum. Only a Dettol mum knows that Dettol cleans away dirt while protecting a family from 100 illness-causing germs, giving her family increased protection. Don't just be any mum, be a Dettol mum. Dettol, be 100% sure.
You have the power to be heard.
Hey, my love.
Our baby has decided today is the day.
What?
It's time to fill up your kitchen, my love.
What's better, let's say, my love?
Hello?
Hello?
Oh.
Yes, who's that?
Go, boy.
Go.
Love, are you there?
Hello.
No
mountain
high, ain't no valley low. No, I'm sorry. Ain't no river
wide enough,
baby.
Do it
again. Yo.
Eh?
Give him your phone.
Yeah, use mine. Thank you so much. Thanks. Which hospital?
Southside Hospital.
Ah, oh, perfect. Hey.
Switch to SA's best network with the least dropped calls. Vodacom, power to you.
Every day, everybody. Effective moisturizing, even for eczema. Just medically proven E45 cream. E45, your skin never felt so good.
The final of the men's tennis competition took place at the Olympic Tennis Centre, with the gold medal awaiting the victor. Great Britain's Andy Murray triumphed in London 4 years ago, and was looking to defend his title against Argentine Juan Martin Del Potro. Murray gave early signals of his intentions and broke Del Potro in his opening service game. Del Potro didn't let Murray have it all his own way, but the Briton powered past the Argentine to take the first set 7-5. Murray, the number two seed, lost a close second set by 6-4. But he recovered in the third set, and in just 36 minutes, he took the set by 6-2. It looked as though Del Potro could take the fourth set when he broke Murray's serve at 3-all. But Murray showed his resolve and fought back and left Del Potro to serve to stay in the match. Murray broke the Argentine once more and took the game, set, match and that gold medal. Final score after 4 hours of superb tennis, 7-5, 4-6, 6-2, 7-5. So the bronze medal goes to Kei Nishikori of Japan. Argentina's Juan Martin Del Potro takes the silver, with Andy Murray of Great Britain claiming the gold medal for the second game's run.
Yeah, it feels amazing. You know, I think it was the match itself was, you know, physically draining. It was emotionally draining. And yeah, I just managed to get through it at the end. But yeah, to win another gold medal, you know, for my country means a lot to me, and yeah, very, very proud.
Well, I'm so proud to get this medal, but I was close to get the other one. But anyways, I think I deserve to get one medal in the end of the tournament. That's a matter of the color, and I'm so happy to get this on my hands. Well, I cannot believe the moment. I didn't expect to get the medal in this event. I'm living like a dream, even more like a dream, and I kind of wake up from this.
The bronze medal match for the mixed doubles. Indian pair Rohan Bopanna and Sania Mirza took on the Czech Republic's Radek Stepanek and Lucy Hradecka, vying for a place on the Olympic podium. The odds didn't look good for the Indian pair after they dropped their first service game. And the Czechs continued their dominance in the opening set, racing into a 5-love lead. They eventually took the first set by 6-1. Bopanna and Mirza were struggling, and that continued into the second set as they failed to hold their serve again. But then they broke back immediately and set up an entertaining and close fourth set. Stepanek and Hradecka always seemed to hold the edge though, and they managed to take the set 7-5, winning the match and the bronze medal.
It means a world, you know, because once every kid starts to do any sport, I think they dream about having this medal on their necks. You know, I wasn't different. I was dreaming about this my whole life. And, you know, after quite a few years, it's here. It's an incredible, magical moment. And it's a big moment for our country.
Well, it was a historic gold for Andy Murray, and it was one of a handful of gold that Great Britain won on day 9 alone. They're now going to second spot on the medal table. South Africa, thanks to this man, Wade van Niekerk, is currently sitting in 24th spot thanks to that gold medal he won in the men's 400 metres. But in 2014 in Glasgow, he won silver at the Commonwealth Games over the one lap, and then a year later, he became the first man ever to run a sub 10-100, sub 20-200, and a sub 44-400. We've been asking you to get interactive with us. How did Wade van Niekerk make you feel? Make use of the hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016. You've been seeing all those tweets coming through, Tipsenardo.
Ah, Shem. You know what, ne?
People, hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016. If you are not dancing like this tweet right here, then I'm not jealous. This is the official dance for the Wade Dreamer. Wade van Niekerk has done the unbelievable. Michael Johnson is sitting at home like, yo, bandra. But this is the official dance, and it's coming from the one and only Veilinho from here. You can understand the energy that's happening here. We're going to read your tweets right now. I have a beautiful tweet that's just showing us that this guy is not... People, thank you very much for just showing us here. We have a tweet that says, Wade, your lekker dank. This is the one that we want. I'm going to show it right now. Here it is from D. Hlubi. And saying, he said, pride of South Africa, Wade, Joe, lekker dank. I can give you exactly how a colored guy is explaining as we speak the greeting that Usain Bolt did. Here's exactly how a colored guy went. It's like, yeah, bruh. Wade just went over there, bruh. Like Bolt, ne? And the journalist come to talk to me and said, Bach, I get something belangrijk om te doen, Joe. Then he went up there, straight up, and went to Wade and said, Wade, Jay. Yo, look at that. Colored people, we have done it, Joe. We have gold. But you know what? In the meantime, let's just get this thing to sink in because we're going to a sport we don't do here, which is shooting. Dupula, dupula, dupula. Away.
The final of the men's 50-meter rifle three positions was held at the Olympic Shooting Center. Competitors shoot from three positions, standing, kneeling, and prone or lying flat. Ultimately, it would be a battle between two shooters. Italy's Niccolò Campiani was back to defend his London 2012 title. He was also looking for his second medal of these games. He'd won gold in the 10-metre air rifle. Campiani was shooting well and led, but Russia's Sergei Kamensky was fighting for the top of the leaderboard. After 30 shots, the two were tied. After 40, there was just 0.3 of a point in it, Kamensky leading. Third-place shooter Alexis Reyno was 4 points adrift. With two shots to go, the fraction between the top two had been lowered to 0.1, the smallest gap possible. Kamensky was in front. A 9.1 from Campiani gave the Russian a lead of almost a full point. The bronze went to Alexis Reyno. He was eliminated and it was down to one last shot and the two shooters who had always been in control. Campiani needed a high score, but he could only hit a 9.2. Kamensky only needed an 8.7 to win gold. The title was surely his. But he crumbled with an 8.3. A shake of the head from Campiani, he couldn't believe it. So, bronze for Alexis Reyno, silver for Sergei Kamensky, he'd come so close, and another gold for Niccolò Campiani.
Today, you know, I made the final by nothing. I was 8th place, so I was very, very lucky to make the final today. It just, you know, I had no energy left. This is my third final in 3 matches, and, you know, also watching my girlfriend shooting, that wasn't easy either. It's insane, you know. Kamensky had a huge lead in the qualification round. I think today he was the best shooter, but you know that these are the rules. We go back to zero, and the last shot is the last shot for everybody. You know, it's not just for me. I had a lot of bad memories, but it's hard for everybody. And I'm sorry that happened to Kamensky today, but you know, I would have been silver medal anyway, so I was already pleased with my performance. The gold is just almost too much.
What was your thoughts when you saw that 9 on that final shot?
That it's over. I mean, I'm in vacation. That was my thought. I'm just so tired, you know. It's just 16 years of shooting, and you know, this is probably my last match, and this is it. You know, I had tons of great memories. This is the last one of a long... a long series, and you know, thank to everybody that made it possible, that were close to me, and thank you so much.
Я, в общем-то, доволен своей работой, несмотря на то, что последний выстрел.
I'm very happy. A silver medal is not the gold medal, so I'm a bit disappointed. But a silver medal is still a medal, so I'm happy with my first medal of the games.
В общем-то, я считаю, что, ну, не все, но практически все удалось. Ну да, я был немного, потому что
I was disappointed with the last shot, but the last shot is like a lottery. It's win or lose.
Это как лотерея. Если получилось, то ты везунчик. Если нет, то увы.
It was a work of 4 years, which I can't criticize today. 4 years of work which involved a lot of sacrifices, but it paid off today.
C'est des gens qu'on côtoie régulièrement, mais c'est vrai que bah, aujourd'hui.
I know all these champions very well, but today it was all about arriving. I don't know what to say. I worked for it. It is simply the compensation. And I'm saying to everyone, I have arrived.
Tout le monde qui a fait en sorte que j'y arrive.
Oh man, these medal-winning moments, they certainly do inspire, as does this man for so many South Africans. And he's been doing that in the build-up to the game. He's been working in collaboration with Cartoon Network and Childline regarding their international anti-bullying campaign, the CN Buddy campaign. It says, be a buddy, not a bully, with the aim of raising awareness and empowering kids against bullying. And when a man can run 43.03 seconds over one lap of a tartan track, then who are you to disagree with him? Great having you in our company. Remember to get in contact with us, making use of the hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016. When we come back, this is what we got for you. It is men's and women's artistic gymnastic in the individual apparatus. Men's pommel horse and floor, and women's vault and asymmetrical bars.
Is your home really healthy? This is why 80% of some illnesses are contracted at home. Some cleaners don't kill germs, others don't clean properly. Dettol 4-in-1 Cleaner is giving you an unbelievable clean, killing 99.9% of germs and leaving you a fresh fragrance. Be 100% sure for a healthier home. This could be you enjoying a Sunday afternoon with the family. But no, you decided an afternoon shopping at the mall would be a better idea.
No, I told you only one toy each.
Listen to your mum, only one toy.
Will it be straight or budget, sir?
With DSTV, fun family moments won't blow your budget. Catch all your favorite DSTV shows in the comfort of your own home. DSTV, feel every moment.
Slidley! Kitchen gets 10 out of 10, you. This also gets a 10. Should we see the toilet now?
Sure.
This gets just 1.
It is clean,
but not a perfect 10.
Better than my bleach? Impossible.
Challenge? Try the new Harpic 10X. Harpic Peak formulation removes stains 10 times better, giving you a sparkling clean toilet.
Wow!
Now you also take the
Harpic 10X challenge.
Well, it's great to have you with us at the Rio Olympic Arena as we prepare for the first session of apparatus finals. The gymnastics has been of an exceptional standard, and with four finals to look forward to today, the athletes, well, we think are sure to impress. We'll have the men's floor, followed by the women's vaults, then the men's pommels, and finally the elegance of the asymmetric or uneven bars for the women. Good crowd coming in as usual here at the Rio Olympic Arena. Both the all-around champions will be in action, hoping to add to their medal haul. Now, Max Whitlock was equal with Ippolito in qualifying with a 15.5. 15.4 in the team competition, 15.2 in the all-around. So needs 15.5 plus.
Run full, up 2.5. Of course, all of these twisting lines, collecting connection bonuses. There's the nice flares up to handstand, hop back down to flares again. That's the Gagliazze with a jump. It's worth a D to him. His landings are really very smooth. Not even a hint of a step. And that's the Kolbczynski. Stretch position.
Oh, Max Whitlock's done a marvellous job. A silver medalist at the World Championships last year. Gives the crowd a smile. He knows that the wishes of the crowd might be with Ippolito or Artur Mariano. So he can't be premature in celebrating for fear of offending the masses.
That's true. And look, the judges have to be impartial. We all know that they do a great job. They have to ignore the crowd support.
And really, we've been so impressed with the open-hearted generosity of applause for all competitors, no matter where they're from these wonderful Brazilian fans. So the result has Whitlock ahead of Ippolito and Mariano. Yeah. The Japanese competitors just out of the medals. Look who's here. It's Simone Biles.
So the final gymnast is winning, representing the United
Already
States.
Gold two times over. Individual all around and team.
Well, the question is not whether she's going to land on her feet, it's whether she can actually stick it cold. Not quite, but it's still beautiful. She really just needs two vaults to her feet to take this title, such as her prowess on this event.
Last three World Championships, 15, 14 and 13, she's finished third, second and second.
You can see the beautiful contact with the horse, completely open shoulders, hips. It's most likely that the gymnasts in finals are not really trying to stick, they're just trying to land on their feet. Sometimes you go for the stick and you misjudge it and you can fall. So it's just try and stand on your feet. If you land it and you stick it, that's a bonus. So it's just an interesting mindset.
So this for the gold, her third at these games. Of course she does.
What's so impressive about Simone Biles is just how cool she is under pressure. Oh, they're not even waiting for the score. She knows she's got it. And she can't be feeling too fresh. She's been through the qualification, all four apparatus, team final, all four. And then the all-around final, all four. Very big cluster of competitions.
Won't see
her. Space of time.
Yeah, won't see her in uneven bars.
Red's the colour, isn't it?
Yeah, Steingruber. Like the others, congratulating this young champion, this diminutive dynamo from Texas.
And that's how it's done. Beautiful alignment on the horse. Coach Amy Borman, who's had her since a very young age. He said they've grown together. She wasn't an elite coach when Simone walked through the door, but she's learned with her, got all the expertise as she's gone along, and look at the result.
Scores in. A modest smile from Simone Biles. And yes, it's gold on vault. Second vault, 16.033. And Simone Biles is the vault Olympic champion in 2016. Confirming the results then, Simone Biles of the United States, Paseka of the Russian Federation, and Steingruber of Switzerland, gold, silver and bronze. Good effort from Kamaka. Can he bring more glory to the Great Britain team? Already gold on floor. third 4 years ago.
Up to him. He's capable of beating Smith. Good rhythm. Doesn't have the same upper body strength as Smith. Looked like he was in trouble for a little moment there. Now he's getting the rhythm going. Can he finish it off? Big routine here. Looking good.
Well done, Whitlock, again. Is it his day? Keeps his emotions under control and yet still shows his delight in taking another gold medal. Max Whitlock claims the pommels ahead of Lewis Smith, both of Great Britain, of course. Alexander Nadeau of the United States, third. Now, Ali Mustafa, gold medalist from London on uneven bars. Won at the Olympics but hasn't won bars at World Championships.
Well, what to watch about this routine is her marvellous internal amplitude, taking every skill to the maximum. It's good, she gets that connection. The way she floats to the bar from one bar to the next, it's just poetic. Once again, finds a nice height on that release. Pirouette done right in vertical. 1.5, can she stick? Almost.
Mustafina lays down a mark for the others to beat. Thanks the crowd for their support and a little bit of the Russian contingent here to see if she can do it.
Very little wrong with that routine. There's the stoop. Just see the way in which she swings has a certain purity about it. Just the way she floats that up straight into the toe on. That's a connection up to the high bar. Nice height on the release.
It's gold down for the Russian Federation. On uneven bars, USA silver, bronze for Germany. Mustafina, Kochian and Sheda.
Well, congratulations to the ladies and the men's and women's artistic gymnastic does continue later on today. But we are celebrating this man and people just cannot get enough of him at Wade Dreamer. Did you know his favorite rugby team is the Stormers? And that's probably, I think, because not only does he hail from the Western Cape, but his cousin Cheslin Colby also plays for the team. And that makes two Rio Olympics medalists in one family. The gold for Wade van Niekerk and the bronze from the sevens rugby for Cheslin Colby. Isn't that fabulous? That's a picture of the great Usain Leonard Bolt congratulating Wade van Niekerk after his victory in the 400 meters. And he actually stopped his post-race interviews to be able to walk up and congratulate Wade van Niekerk. What a man. I don't think sprinting has been this exciting for a very, very long time. It's time now to shift focus from athletics. We will continue to celebrate Wade van Niekerk throughout the show. But from gymnastics, we move on to wrestling. This is the men's 75 kilogram final.
The first wrestling medals of the Rio Games were awarded in the Greco-Roman sub-59 kilogram category. Contesting the first of two bronze medal matches were Uzbekistan's Elmurat Tasmuradov and Arsen Iraliyev of Kyrgyzstan. After being 5 points down, Iraliyev went ahead with this move. He gained 4 points for elevation and the full rotation of his opponent. Tasmuradov quickly reasserted his authority with two successive scoring moves, including this throw, which only gained him 2 points because he couldn't complete the rotation. Tasmuradov stayed ahead until the end of the 6 minutes to clinch the medal. In the other bronze medal contest, Stig-Andre Berger of Norway faced Azerbaijan's Rovshan Bayramov, the silver medalist at the last two Olympic Games. It was a match characterised by cautious wrestling. The only points scored were because of penalties for being too passive. It ended 1-1, but because Berger was the last to score a point, he won the match and the bronze medal. In the gold medal match, the world title holder Ismael Barrero Molina of Cuba challenged Japan's Shinobu Ota. It took 2.5 minutes until the first score, but it came in style when Barrero Molina managed to lift Ota and throw him with a full rotation for 4 points. He then rolled his opponent for a further 2 points. If Barrero Molina scored the next 2 points, the match would be over. Ota was powerless to prevent his opponent from securing an 8-0 lead, which ended the fight and made Barrero Molina the Olympic champion. The bronze medals were won by Norway's Stig Andre Berger and Elmurat Tasmuradov of Uzbekistan. Japan's Shinobu Ota took silver, and Ismael Barrero Molina of Cuba claimed gold.
En mi red no siento nada. Es muy, muy complicado saber que soy campeón olímpico.
It's a very complicated feeling. I'm really glad to be an Olympic champion. It's a lot of emotions, so hard to explain.
Fue campeón mundial. Y me ratifico como el mejor del mundo ahora mismo siendo campeón mundial y campeón olímpico. El partido final es un rival a considerar ya que...
It went really fast, but I was able to be the stronger athlete and come out on top.
Más rivales que son mucho más fuertes que él.
I felt like I didn't do it properly, and my Cuban opponent was able to take control of the match, so I wasn't able to follow up with that. I came here to get the gold medal. That was my ultimate goal. I believe that I practiced trying to get the gold, but my practice ended up being second place material. The next Olympics will be in Tokyo in 2020. And for that, I'll practice even harder to make sure I'll get the gold medal.
I am so, so happy. Really, really happy. My opponent was very tough, so I'm delighted. I want to thank my president, my coach, and my family. Thanks to them, I've come a long, long way. It has all been very difficult, but right now, I couldn't be happier. The most difficult moment for me today was the match when I lost against the Cuban in the semifinals, who went on to win the gold medal. It was difficult for me to lose to him, but now I'm thrilled.
Of course, this is my third Olympics. First two Olympics, I lost the first match and then straight back to Norway. Now I have a medal. Now I have a medal in European, World and Olympics. It's amazing.
What were the key points in that last match?
It's only to have a good speed because we are equals and it's not many points every time I meet him. It's only 1, 2, maybe 2 points. So it's a hard match and we knew that, but I'm happy now.
When you get up on that podium, how do you think you'll feel in front of these fans?
I think I'm going to cry, but still this bronze medal is like gold for me.
And that's what the Olympics does. It brings grown men to tears. But this man brought us to tears. Tears of joy this morning, Wade van Niekerk. And you know that he's not the only member of his family to win a medal at the Olympic Games. His cousin, Cheslin Kolbe, won bronze with the South African Sevens rugby team last week. Van Niekerk had a large number of his family at the stadium to witness his record-breaking run. And there's a picture of him with his family. That's absolutely brilliant. And you actually see next to him is his brother, who's an Arsenal fan, and asked after that world record run, because Wade van Niekerk himself is a big Liverpool fan. So he says, you know, in the build-up to the race, I watched that Premier League match, because of course the English Premier League, the new season got underway, and there was a big clash, Liverpool up against Arsenal at Arsenal, and Liverpool won 4-3. He said that now I've got two things to brag about, Liverpool winning and the fact that I got a world record.
See how bored I am. Look at my face now. They said wrestling. You know, I was there waiting for John Cena. Nothing. There, thinking something would be like, nothing. Looking at your tweet right now, we are all about Wade van Niekerk. Don't even want to try and be famous. Here's Kolani Zuke, who's saying, like, this is a beautiful tweet, saying, let's go Rio 2016. Van Niekerk, I'm so happy to be breathing in your lifetime. You are the greatest. Bona, there's no better tweet. You know what? Let's take a break. Really, Tsenyana, I really gold and everything. But after the break, cycling, Papa. Post office cycling after the break.
up. Today is your day. Now take a step on forward and get on your way. You know what you know. The world's just waiting to meet you today.
With you on your journey. Engine. With us, you are number one.
Bronze medal, second race. That is going to be a fascinating battle for the bronze medal here between Denis Dimitriev and Matt Glaitzer. Glaitzer has to do it twice in order to get into the medals here, because he lost the opening race against the powerful Russian.
The pressure's on this man, Matthew Glaitzer. Can he take it to three rides? One ride already going to meet Dimitriev for the bronze medal.
So away they roll. Matt Glaitzer has it all to do here. Win this and they go to a decider. Lose, and that man, Dimitriev, takes the bronze medal.
Well, Glaitzer rode the first ride from the back. He was unable to come around Dimitriev. Will he take this one on from the front? Or will he try again from the back? Sometimes they go away and analyze with their coaches what they did wrong, but in many cases, they ride a perfect race and still get beaten, so tactical. And the speed of this Russian Dimitriev, he has really nailed his form here. He looks very relaxed.
Doesn't he? I was about to say, does he just...
Sending a signal there, yeah, to Matt Glaitzer. I've got this. I'm really confident. I know I've got the legs.
So they're winding it up now in the bronze medal race two. Glaitzer has to win to stay alive for a medal here. The bell goes. Dimitriev is hunting down his prey. Glaitzer is on the front now. Dimitriev pulling up alongside behind him. He's going to go past him on this bend. Can he go all the way, though? It's for the bronze medal. Glaitzer's holding on. Dimitriev is going to get it. Bronze medal to Russia. Bronze to Dimitriev.
Well, he's too strong on the day. Glaitzer, he tried everything. He tried the first ride from the back. The second ride he took on from the front. But Dimitriev, what a powerful display. What a performance. Bronze medal.
This is the gold medal race. Race number two. Jason Kenny, defending champion. Four times an Olympic gold medalist. Up against the younger fellow countryman, his roommate in the Great Britain team, Callum Skinner. Kenny leads 1-0, a win here, and he will join the greats of sprinting. Jens Fiedler, the last to win back-to-back gold medals in the sprint back in 92 and 96.
Well, Jason Kenny looks well on his way to matching that. He won the first ride against his fellow countryman, Callum Skinner. He'll have the confidence of the two in this ride, just leading out from the front, keeping a close eye on Skinner. He knows everything about this rider. They've spent so many hours together training. Teammates in the team sprint, both having won here in Rio, the team sprint gold medal. Jason Kenny keeps such a close eye. Can't afford to take his eye off Skinner for one moment.
They'll know the tactics. They'll know each other inside out.
They'll not only know their physical strength and weaknesses because they spend so much time together, they'll also know the mental weaknesses and strengths. Skinner now tries to take some height on the track. Jason Kenny keeping a close eye on him.
Calm, Kenny, calm, as they start winding it up now.
Well, he can't be too calm. Skinner on the top of the track, trying to force Kenny into the sprint lane. Kenny stays high.
This is for the gold medal in the men's sprint. Jason Kenny on the front. His countryman, Callum Skinner, chasing him down. Kenny's got the strength. Has Skinner got it to come around him? It's Kenny who's going to get the gold. It's another gold medal. The defending champion does it again. Jason Kenny, a fifth Olympic gold medal. Callum Skinner, the bronze medal. But what a ride. What a performance all week from Jason Kenny.
Absolutely incredible. Two gold medals here in Rio. Back-to-back Olympic sprint titles. everything to be happy about here. He's a four-year campaigner for Olympic Games. His fiancée, Laura Trott, also winning a gold medal here in Rio. Back-to-back London 2012 and 2016 for both that couple of Jason Kenny and Laura Trott. What a successful Olympic campaign.
Absolutely amazing. Broad smile from Jason Kenny. Jens Fiedler last won it back-to-back in 92 and 96. Before that, Daniel Moreno, 68 and 72. Now Jason Kenny, 2012 and 2016. This is how he did it. Callum Skinner, well, he's the one man who has pushed this Jason Kenny all the way, but not good enough to take a race off him here in the final.
Well, Skinner at 23 years of age, that's a bright future for British cycling in the men's sprint discipline. Chris Hoy will be delighted to see two men from Great Britain in the final here. Gold goes to Jason Kenny.
Well, that's five Olympic gold medals for Jason Kenny. Three in the men's team sprint, three in a row, and two now in the sprint, individual sprint.
He'll make his way up to see family and celebrate.
What a lovely moment for Jason Kenny, the gold medalist in the sprint once again for Great Britain. Their fourth gold medal at Rio 2016. And huge support as well for all the British riders here.
He wants to get over there in the crowd. So much support from family and friends goes into producing a phenomenal athlete like this one, Jason Kenny. It's not just about the individual, but it's about your support crew, it's about your family, it's about your partners, and it's about your friends and fans. They have so much influence over rising to the occasion. And Jason Kenny does it again.
Plenty of emotion. Callum Skinner, well, he's the silver medalist at the Olympic Games, the 23-year-old. He'll be pretty pleased with that, won't he?
Absolutely.
You can get carried away and forget about Skinner. You cannot, because his performance suggests that he will be around for many years to be back on an Olympic track to challenge for the gold medal.
Well, a lot about the performances of Jason Kenny can be contributed to this man, Callum Skinner. He's been by his side, mentally and physically, through all the training sessions, pushing him to his absolute best.
Well, he joins Bradley Wiggins and Sir Steve Redgrave as British athletes to win five gold medals at the Olympic Games. Jason Kenny wins the men's sprint ahead of Callum Skinner in the silver medal position. A 1-2 for Great Britain, with Russia, the world bronze medalist, backing it up with an Olympic bronze medal.
And that gold medal was one of a handful won in different sports yesterday by Great Britain. For South Africa, though, we'll continue celebrating this gold from Wade van Niekerk. Now, the Cape Town-born star arrived in Rio with form. His winning time at the Beijing World Championships last year was 43.48 seconds. And in his slipstream that day, taking bronze, was London 2012 champion Karani James. And in silver, LeSean Merritt. That pair filled the minor placings again in Rio, only in a different order. Ichane became South Africa's first sprint world champion, and he's also South Africa's first gold medalist in a pure track event at the Olympic Games since readmission. Wade van Niekerk certainly has made the country very proud. Remember, you can continue to send in your comments, making use of the hashtag Let's Go Rio 2016. Let's jump into weightlifting now with the over 75 kilogram weight division for ladies. And China, they ensured with a gold medal in that category, they ensured that for the fifth games running, they ended at the top of the medal table when it comes to the sport at the games.
The final of the plus 75 kilogram category in women's weightlifting at Rio Centro. The winner would be the woman to lift the highest combined weights across two elements. Up first, the snatch. Suping Meng of China managed 125 kilos on her second lift, showing how the bar must be lifted from the platform, then above the head, using the full extent of the arms. The USA's Sarah Robles looked confident for her third lift of 126 kilos and was delighted with the results. Meng of China was attempting 130 kilos on her last lift and did it. Could Hwang Kuk Kim of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea go 1 kilo better? She got there, taking first place after the snatch. Suping Meng of China was in second, and Sarah Robles of the USA was in third. On to the clean and jerk. The clean, where the bar is lifted from the floor to the shoulders while a competitor drops into a squat. Then the jerk, where lifters stand, raising the bar above their head. A successful lift of 160 kilos for the USA's Sarah Robles, who couldn't contain her excitement. Hwang Kuk Kim of the PRK managed 175 kilos with this lift. But Meng of China went on to attempt 2 kilos more on her last lift, 177 kilos on the bar. At the end of the competition, the bronze medal went to the USA's Sarah Robles, silver to Hwang Kuk Kim from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and Suping Meng of China won gold.
Still, I'm just very nervous. I can't feel nothing else, just nervous.
Didn't you expect this gold medal?
I think if I'm lucky enough, I will get another gold medal for the next Olympics.
And how hard have you tried for this?
I have been working really hard for this. I have been consistently training.
I feel awesome. I feel like I can like run through a house right now. I feel so strong. I feel great.
Did you expect this?
I was really hoping it. You know, the way the competition ran was very fast, and I did the weights that I needed to. I had a great coaching staff, and I'm glad it turned out more than we expected.
And how hard have you tried for this?
How hard? Oh, very hard. I mean, I've given up everything else in my life to try to train for this and make this dream of mine come true. Very, very hard.
What kind of sacrifices?
You know, anything from financial to, you know, just things that you deal with every day. You know, sometimes you hear bad things, sometimes you hear good things. Money, time, relationships, you know, friends in your life. You know, you have to really isolate yourself to focus on what you're doing. And I'm glad I was able to tough it out for that while.
Hard.
Yes, it's very, very hard.
And you had someone cheering for you here tonight.
Yes, my mom was here. That was great. My sports psych guy came. My coach is here. You know, all the people that are most important to me are here. I wish my family, you know, the rest of my family were able to be here, but that's what TV's for, right?
And that bronze medal for Sarah Robles of the United States, it was the first weightlifting medal for her nation since 2000. We continue to celebrate Wade van Niekerk, and when we return from the break, we're going to bring you not only his 400-meter final, but we're also going to be bringing you what happened in the men's 100-meter final featuring the great Usain Bolt. Stay with us.
The SABC has signed a code of conduct that is enforced by the Broadcasting Complaints Commission of South Africa. Under the code, we are committed to giving news that is accurate, comment that's fair, and programming that is not harmful, does not amount to hate speech or violence or explicit sex. If you think we are not living up to that code, then you can inform the Broadcasting Complaints Commission of South Africa. Direct any complaints in writing to the BCCSA. P.O. Box 412-365, Craig Hall 2024. Send a fax to 011-326-3198 or an email to bccsa@nabsa.co.za. For more information, please visit bccsa.co.za.
A
official sponsor of the South African Olympic and Paralympic teams. Telkom, proud sponsor of Speed.
Usain Bolt is the main course tonight. But if this is a starter, it could be hot enough to burn your mouth and get the taste buds tingling. The men's 400 metres. Three of the greatest 400 runners, certainly of the last 10 years and arguably of all time. LaShawn Merritt, the Olympic champion in Beijing, goes in five. Kerani James, the defending Olympic champion, in six. And Wade van Niekerk, the reigning world champion, on the outside, running blind in lane eight. They are three of the 10 fastest athletes in history. Van Niekerk, the poster boy of South African athletics, the flag bearer for them. 43-48 when he won in Beijing last year. No South African has won this title for 96 years. A century of history beckons for Van Niekerk. Matthew Hudson-Smith, what a run in the semi-finals for a new lifetime best, 44-48. Could he get close to Ewan Thomas's 1997 British record? Kerani James, 23 years of age, he's won it all. A world title in Daegu, the Olympic title in 2012, and this is the one he is so desperate to defend. Only Michael Johnson has ever done that. LaShawn Merritt, so consistent, twice a world champion, sixth fastest athlete in history. Can he recapture the crown he is so desperate to attain? Raylon Taplin, also flying the flag for Grenada. Massive PB this year, 44-38. Could he upset this triumvirate of excellence? And Marcel Cedillo, Pan American silver medalist from Trinidad and Tobago. Massive talent, 44-34 behind Van Niekerk in Monaco. He is really, really quick, and he won't be intimidated by the big men outside him. Ali Karmis, World Junior Championship silver a couple of years ago. The slowest man to qualify in 44-49. That's the quality on display here. And Karabo Sibanda, African Championship silver medalist, World Junior bronze medalist. Amazing to have him in the final. He's only 18. Can you imagine the adrenaline? Three men at the very peak of their powers, but only one will touch greatness tonight. Merritt in five, Kerani James in six, Van Niekerk on the outside in eight. All three ran under 44 seconds in Beijing. It was one of the great, great finals, and this has the making of another. The men's 400 metres. So who's going to succumb to the adrenaline first? Van Niekerk is running blind on the outside and he's set off really quickly. Kerani James in hot pursuit. He's already up onto the shoulder of Matthew Hudson-Smith. And Merritt is tracking the Grenadian. The American, LaShawn Merritt, closing the gap on Kerani James. And Van Niekerk still wide on the outside. These three are away and clear. Cedinho's tried to come back into it on the inside. And LaShawn Merritt coming back at Kerani James. But it's Van Niekerk leading at the moment. The South African now beginning to tire. Or is he? He's pulling away. It's an unbelievable victory by a huge margin. A century of history. And 43-03. I can't believe it. He has obliterated Michael Johnson's world record. It was destined to be one of the great races and one of the great days. We haven't even seen Usain Bolt yet, and this has ignited the stadium. Where did that performance come from? The world champion is the Olympic champion and the world record holder. It's a performance to set the hairs on the back of your neck tingling. We've never seen anything like it in an Olympic final. Incredible.
The buzz around this stadium is remarkable. And so was that performance. Just exceptional. Van Niekerk taking it out and having to run with all of his main dangers behind him. And that's where they stayed. They could not even get level with him. And there's the line that he crossed in a time that nobody has ever done more quickly and more brilliantly. And the nation of South Africa will be rejoicing now. They've been talking about him as a future Olympic champion for some time to come. Now he is one, and he's not only that. He's the quickest man over 400 metres there has ever been. Kerani James could not get to him. He's run sensationally to run 43.76. LaShawn Merritt was brave as well in 43.85. And Cedinho has run a national record at 44.01. But the night belongs to the South African.
That was utterly, utterly breathtaking. Merritt, 43.85 for the bronze. The slowest athlete in that race was Great Britain's Matthew Hudson-Smith, and even he ran 44.61. National record for Ali Khamis of Bahrain. National record for Machel Cedinho of Trinidad and Tobago. Imagine running 44.01, 44.01, and finishing fourth. It's the first time in Olympic history that three men have run inside 44 seconds, but it was so fast from Van Niekerk, it was almost inside 43.
Well, that was probably the race of the games. Usain may do something special on an individual basis, but look at the replay and look at the way he kept his nerve. And when you run in lane eight, you have to stick to a plan. And he was bold early, and he got a lead on James and Merritt, and he was ripe for the picking, but they could never do it. And look at the way the South African strides away. Halfway up the straight, he was a couple of metres in front. He's won by five or six. That is a truly extraordinary performance.
All three of these men have lived up to their star-studded billing. It's not as if James and Merritt folded and produced nothing. They both ran incredibly quick times. 43.76 and 43.85 for silver and bronze. Brilliant runs from both of them. But it was on another level there from Wade van Niekerk. The way he accelerated in the last 50 metres was something to behold.
He is the world record holder. He is the Olympic record holder. He is the reigning Olympic champion, and he stands with history beckoning. There is the start list for the final of the men's 100. In the eyes of many people, a match in two between Justin Gatlin, the 2004 champion, and Usain Bolt, the 2008 and 2012 champion.
378 fabulous runners for you in lane two, Brumell.
Trayvon Brumell, world indoor
lane
champion.
Three, Symphony.
Tony Simbine, African record holder. Gap from the United States. The polarizing figure he's been. He's going back from the reaction of the crowd. Lico of France, co-European record holder. At 21 years of age, the youngest man in the final. Ben Mighty, carrying the hopes of Cote d'Ivoire. And Johan Blake, Bolt's fellow Jamaican. It's been a moment that has been 120 years in the making. The modern Olympic Games. Is Usain Bolt about to rewrite the record books again?
fifth.
Gatlin got a good enough start. Bolt was a bit slow to begin. He's got some work to do. Gatlin's in front. Bolt stretching out now. He's coming after him. He's immortal now. Usain's done it. Gatlin challenged for the silver medal. 9.80. To London and now to Rio. It is one of the greatest athletic achievements of all time, if not the very greatest. What a moment. He wasn't great out of the blocks. Gatlin beat him out clearly. Usain had to work. In the end, it was comfortable. Gatlin will take the silver medal by 0.02, and the Canadian Andre de Grasse will be the bronze medalist. You have just seen a moment the likes of which none of us is ever likely to see again in this lifetime, or any lifetime for that matter.
Watch Gatlin here. He's clearly ahead at this point. And you started to think, is this Gatlin's day? And little by little, the gap closed. He was tight in the shoulders, Usain Bolt. Only in the last 3 or 4 metres did we see that right fist coming up onto the left chest. He's working here. Those big, long legs, famously carrying him to the finish line in 43 strides. But it was only in the last 10 metres that he managed to get there. And you could see there, Gatlin let out a roar of desperation, because at 50 metres, he must have been thinking, maybe this time I've actually beaten him. It was a brilliant race to watch.
Have a look from another angle. There's the start. Their reaction times were not that much different.
Second slowest, though, for Bolt.
And look at him here. Watch these strides right here. He goes from a metre behind there to a metre in front. And it was beyond doubt then, and he even had time to celebrate.
And Bolt was just asking the interviewers there, give me 1 minute, there's someone I must go and see in the crowd. Yeah. He's gone up to embrace Wade van Niekerk. Yeah. There they are. What a moment for both of them. And what a mark of respect from Bolt to Wade van Niekerk.
Official sponsor of the South African Olympic and Paralympic teams, Telkom, proud sponsor of Speed.
Today is a new day, so tell me, what are you gonna do?
Gonna get a nice and early.
Louder!
What does it mean to be part of such a historic final?
It's a blessing, but I give the Lord all credit. I left everything on the track. I left everything in God's hands, and he pulled me through very strong tonight.
The world record, how does that feel?
It's a real blessing. I just can't wait to get to my family and celebrate with them.
How did you do it?
I just gave it my all. I left it all in God's hands. I give the Lord all the credit for tonight.
What was the feeling crossing the line, seeing what you'd achieved?
It's a really unreal feeling. I felt, and I thought that I was going to feel the other guys come up on me, but I felt I was alone at the last race, and I just tried fighting all the way to the finish line.
You mentioned your family. How emotional will it be to go and get an embrace with them now?
It was amazing to just go out to my family and give them each and every one of them a hug. Seeing how delighted they were tonight, it's a blessing.
And your coach, Anne, how much does she mean to you?
I haven't seen her yet, so I'm on my way to get to the back so I can get to her as soon as possible.
And how do you think South Africa will celebrate this?
No, it means the world to my country. Hopefully I can inspire so much more South Africans to do what I'm doing today.
Usain, how does it feel to be the first to 3 Olympic sprint titles?
Feels great. There's no words. This is what I came here for, and I came here and I did it. It's a good start to the championship now. Let's take it a step at a time.
How did you achieve it?
Well, it's just hard work. I told you guys that this season I got a little setback, but I was in much better shape than last season, so it wasn't going to be as close, and I proved that today.
How did you deal with that injury setback? Were there ever doubts?
No, you're going to always have people doubt you, but I never doubted myself. I always give thanks to God. He really came through for me on this one, so I have to give thanks.
After London, you called yourself a legend. What does this make you?
Somebody said unstoppable. I'll be unstoppable or, no, immortal. That's the word they use. So two more to go to sign off on immortal.
What will it mean to do that, to continue this streak?
It will mean the world. I came out here to prove to the world that I'm the greatest, and that's what I did. And I'm proud of myself and the execution that I came out and did. I'm happy.
What kind of party will there be back in Jamaica right now?
It's going to be crazy because people have been calling me all day, cheering me on. So I'm just happy that I got the execution right, and I'm proud of myself and I'm proud of God. So thanks for the support.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Well, South Africans certainly do love Usain Bolt now, not only because he is a great sprinting champion, but also because of that humility he showed by going up to Wade van Niekerk following his world record run. And many people are asking, what exactly did Usain Bolt say? Well, I'll give you that in a short while after I just tell you about this medal table. Thanks to Wade van Niekerk's gold medal, we have now jumped up to 24th place on the medal table. Remember, here's where else you can check out Olympic action. Tonight, they're going to be speaking about I'm sure Wade van Niekerk and the Olympic football, because we are into the semi-final stage when it comes to the Olympic football on Soccer Zone tonight. And then tomorrow morning I'll be joining you for an update on Morning Live, 7:15 through to 7:30. What did Usain Bolt say to Wade van Niekerk? This is what Wade said. Usain has been such a rock, inspiring me as an athlete. He told me in Jamaica that you'll break the world record, and then he came to me afterwards and said, I told you that you could do it. As we come to the end of This Is Rio for today, thank you very much for staying with us. I will see you again on Wednesday, but Lelo Mzaka and Tipsinardo Shampoonizer are with you tomorrow, 10 to 12, here on SABC2 for another edition of This Is Rio. Until then, goodbye.